Two men fighting for the Republican nomination for governor hashed out a slew of issues during a live debate last night.
But today, WESH 2 News digs deeper into one of the sharpest claims raised by one of those candidates against his opponent. WESH 2 political reporter Greg Fox live with us now. Greg, what's this all about?
Well, it has to do with Rick Scott and one of his major companies. Remember, he started the Columbia HCA hospital chain and was then forced to resign before the company was fined $1.7 billion for fraud. Tonight, his opponent, Bill McCollum, is calling for an investigation of allegations against Scott's new medical company.
It was committing fraud. The allegation came less than 15 minutes into Thursday's debate.
Are you still continuing to commit fraud today, your companies?
Bill McCollum asking his Republican rival in the governor's race, Rick Scott, if he was again connected to a company breaking the law. The claim is centered on the Solantic Urgent Care Clinics, in which Scott is a major investor. The company is based in Jacksonville, but has a strong local presence with a dozen clinics just in Metro Orlando. Duval Circuit Court records show Scott gave testimony in a civil lawsuit brought by a doctor claiming Solantic falsely listed the doctor as its medical director. Filing false licensing information is a crime. But Scott's company and court records might never be made public because Solantic settled and documents are sealed.
I think he should make all it public. I can't imagine how he can win this race and run and become governor and continue to do all this and talk about any issues other than his record if he doesn't come clean on all this.
Scott points out he does not run Solantic, but credits the CEO with running a good company that sometimes deals with problem employees.
You build a big company like she's built, you have disgruntled employees. And so disgruntled employees, they file lawsuits.
Scott did not want to answer questions about nine other legal actions listed in court files and allegations by past employees that Solantic discriminates against people because of weight and ethnic or racial origin.
That's a great company.
But it's not something where people are being discriminated against, in your view.
Absolutely not.
For his part, Scott correctly points out that he was not charged with any crime in relation to the Columbia HCA fraud case in the late 90s. And he's also correct in stating that it is not unusual for big companies, especially healthcare companies, to face legal actions. Martha, Jason.
Great.